A painting is an image formed on a surface such as paper or canvas using pigments. Painting is the act of applying paint to a surface. Paint can be used to make a painting or it can be utilized more practically as a protective covering or decorative element. Paintings are a type of visual art that uses a two-dimensional surface to convey the expression of ideas and feelings. Painting is the application of paint or another substance to a solid surface, most commonly a canvas. A paintbrush is widely used to apply paint or other forms of color. Artists, on the other hand, employ a variety of tools such as sponges, spray paint, and even knives. The term painting is used in the art world to refer to both the act of painting and the artwork that results from it. Painting is both an action and a product created by an artist. It informs us about artistic expression and represents abstract notions. Painting provides students with an instructive as well as enjoyable and stimulating experience. Painting helps children develop hand-eye coordination, which is a crucial ability at their age. This is honed as students learn to paint the parts they see, ensuring that their hand movement matches their vision. On the other hand, a teaching strategy is a way for a teacher to communicate information to his or her students. It is critical to have a diverse set of instructional strategies. So here are some teaching strategies in teaching painting in elementary grades. Let's begin with brainstorming. Brainstorming is a great deal of fun. Students develop a large list of ideas while learning to paint by brainstorming. Teachers can use brainstorming as a thinking strategy to help students generate ideas, ask questions, and investigate a central theme, particularly in the art of painting. During brainstorming, students exchange and record thoughts that come to mind without passing judgment on them. Teachers can use brainstorming sessions to determine what pupils already know about painting and to create opportunities for learning and reflection. Number 2, jigsaw. This strategy increases students' engagement, encourages collaboration, and results in better learning, especially in painting. Number 3, effective lecturing. Monologue and slide presentations are common in lecture sessions, which are often held in huge halls with auditorium-style fixed seating that prioritizes material delivery above interaction and complicated learning. Different techniques for lecturing that add more active and participatory components, thus boosting higher degrees of thinking and learning in teaching painting, should be considered by instructors. Number 4, group work. Collaborative learning can be a powerful method in the classroom for teaching painting. Students can use group work to identify and address knowledge gaps and misconceptions, strengthen their conceptual frameworks, increase their public reasoning and team-based skills, and free up teachers to enable students to pursue higher-order thinking skills. Number 5, flipped classroom. In a flipped classroom, material that would be normally be covered in class is offered outside of class using media such as video lectures or digital modules. The remainder of class time is devoted to the development of knowledge through active learning tactics such as discussion and group activities. Flipping the classroom has been demonstrated to boost students' conceptual understanding of the subject beyond memorization and fundamental painting knowledge, as well as the classroom climate's variety and inclusivity.